All right, well, friends, let's talk about living faith. How do we live our faith day to day? So let's explore that question. Now, some of you know that I just turned a birthday this week. So I turned the good old 50 this last week. And I started to think about this, and I'm realizing that over my lifetime, you know, you have bumps and bruises, and you know, you have some scars, and I don't know if you can relate to that, but I don't know, can you guys relate? Do you guys have like some bumps and bruises and some damage here and there, some scars, some, you know, that have remained, some past hurts? Well, I want to share with you today how I see those past hurts and those past scars. I received a card from my family, and this card says the following. It has a verse from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, starting 7 to 10. And here's what this says: but we have this treasure, and it talks about the treasure, which is the light of God, the treasure of God in jars of clay, to show that this all-surpassing power is from God, not from us. We are hated, and we are oppressed. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed. Perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. Struck down, but not destroyed. And it goes on and on and on. But I want to, and I've used this in a sermon before, but I want to share with you what I received. This is my gift. And it's a bowl. And it's a bowl that's been broken. And this broken bowl has even a chip missing. You see that? Look at that. This is a broken bowl. And sometimes we look at broken bowls like this, or broken people, and then we think they're not worth anything. But this broken bowl was mended, and is mended with gold. See that? There's these little cracks that have been fixed with gold. And instead of throwing this bowl out like garbage, it's being turned into a work of art. Even the place where the crack is missing is filled with gold. You see how beautiful this is? I absolutely love it. It's a bowl that was cracked, but now it's filled with gold. And let me tell you, your life and my life could be like that, right? Our society could every day could say, you know what? You're broken. You're so broken, I'm going to throw you out. You're so broken that you're not worth anything. You're so broken that you're garbage. But you know what? Day to day, our living faith, God says, no way. No way are you garbage. As a matter of fact, those broken things, that brokenness inside you, I'm going to turn into a work of art. So your life, day to day, turns from a broken bowl to a work of art. You are God's workmanship, the passage says in the scripture. We are God's workmanship. We are his beautiful work of art. So friends, let me tell you this. Day to day, our faith, our living faith, might be small, might be broken. It might got some dents and bruises. There might be days when you think, man, I wish this faith thing would be easier. Well, let me tell you, God takes that brokenness. It takes those pieces and puts them together. So our day-to-day becomes a work of art. And not only for us, but we have the chance to reach out to people that are broken, to reach out to people that are in pieces. And you say, you know what? Come with us. Come with us, because you are part of a work of art. You are valued. You are loved. And because of that, God wants to put those pieces in such a way that you become a work of art. I love the fact that people that are broken, they serve. You know what? If you have it all together, you're probably not in a good spot to serve. If you think you have it all going on, and you're the cat's meow, I'm not sure the Lord is going to use you a whole lot. But when you're broken, when you realize that you have things that you need to work on, when you realize that you are not what you ought to be, and that there's pieces in your life that require God's intervention, that's when God uses you. Friends, let me encourage you in your faith, in your living faith, that you approach everything with humility and you bring your broken pieces before the Master.